Today I want to show you how to take a simple piece of footage and turn it into this. If you want to learn how to do this in Filmora, stick around. I'll show you how.
Hit the subscribe button and click the notification bell to be part of the conversation.
I'm going to move a little bit slower for you today so you can follow exactly through this process. To start, what I'm going to need is actually six tracks. So I'm going to go down to the track manager, open that up, and I'm going to choose to add five more tracks into our project. Now you'll see why I'm doing this. I've got this piece of drone footage. I want to bring that down into track number four. This is going to be our main footage. I found this piece of footage free on pixabay.com, but it's kind of cool. The takeoff of that drone is a little bit weird, so let me just get rid of that. I'm going to clip the beginning. I don't quite love the colors of this one. It feels very much like a piece of video, so let me left-click on that, go up to the color tab in the upper left, scroll down to 3D LUT, and I'm going to load one of my personal LUTs that I gave away called the Naturalizer. I'm also going to bring the saturation and the brightness up just a bit, maybe to about 17, just to make that footage pop a little bit more. Now, when I get to about the point that I think I want the text to come in, I'm going to split this footage. And I'm going to move that section by left-clicking and holding and dragging it down into track number one. Now, the reason I did this is I want this piece of footage to change a bit. So there's things I'm going to add to it. The first thing I want to do is add my text, and I'm going to add that right where that split starts. In the upper left, I'll choose the Titles tab, and under Titles, I'm just going to grab the default titles and bring that down into the track right above my main footage, track number five. Let me stretch that out so it's equal. And if I left-click on that, in the upper left, I can adjust this titling. I want it to say Los Angeles. It defaults to the Roboto medium font, but I want to change that. I'm going to use the Abril Fat Face font. And I'm going to increase the font size. Let me get it up to about 105. Let me stretch that out a little bit. Now I want to center this, so if I left click on it and move it in the upper preview window, you'll see a center green line shows up right when I nail center. And I also want this to sit right about on the horizon. So let me put it right about there. Now that text doesn't look bad, but you can see it kind of gets lost with the background, and we really want this text to pop out. So here's a cool trick you might want to pay attention to because you can use it in a lot of different situations. Back under your Media tab in the upper left, in the drop-down you'll see an option for Sample Colors. Grab the black and bring that down into track number two right above the second half of that footage, and let's stretch it out so it covers the whole thing. Now, right now, you might be looking and saying, well, what does that do? It just turns my whole screen black. But if you double left click on it, and in the upper left in the compositing tab, if you dial that back to about maybe 35 or so, what it does is it darkens out that footage a bit and makes it less prominent. This is a trick I do a lot when I want to pull back the background and have the foreground track really pop forwards. Now that looks better, but the text isn't quite popping the way I want it to, so let me double left click on that text down in my timeline, and I'm going to choose the Advanced tab. And if I scroll down on the left, you'll see I have an option to add a text shadow. Let me tick that box, and you can automatically see some shadowing shows up. That's probably a little harsher than I really would like it to be. I'm going to change the angle of the shadow by clicking on the shadow option and move it to the other side. And then I'm going to scroll down, and I'm going to pull back the opacity of that a bit so it's not quite as strong. Below that, I'm going to open up the blur, and that'll give it less of a harsh line and make it just feel like it's throwing a shadow back onto the background. Perfect. Let's choose OK. And the next thing I want to do is I want to add a very specific animation to this. So while I'm still in this text tab in the upper left, I want to find the round zoom out animation. That gives this a kind of cool introduction. Now there's another piece of text I want to put on top of this. So I'll go up to the upper left, choose the Titles tab again, and I'm going to use that same default title and bring that down as well. This is the part where I wrote the greetings from. I want this to feel more like it's handwritten, so I'm going to go down and I'm going to find Seago Script. And I'm going to put that at a very slight angle, and I'm going to bring that up to the upper left. I don't really love the color white, so I'm going to do this. In the upper left, I can choose the text color option. I'm going to choose more and pick a really bright yellow that I think might be good for this effect. I also want it to pop a little more, so I'm going to open up the Advanced tab again, and I'm going to scroll down on the left and choose the text shadow option again. Let me change the shadow so it's to the left, just like the text below. Let me pull back the opacity so it's not such a strong effect. And I'm going to tighten it up so the distance isn't quite as far. And I'll click OK. Now this last track, number 3, I want to do something slightly different. Because this is a postcard, I want to add a border to it and actually make it feel like a postcard. So in the upper left, under Effects, I'll click on Included, and I'll search for Border. Let me bring that border down into this track number 3, right on top of this black track. And see how that does a really cool border there? Now if I double left click on it, I can adjust it and make that border size bigger or smaller, or blur it out a bit. Or I could even pull back the opacity if it was too strong, or change the color. But I actually want that pretty harsh line with no blur, and the size set at about 3 seems to do pretty cool things. Now there's one other trick that I'm gonna do. Right now, if I started playing this, when it hit this change, it would just be a really harsh transition. So I'm gonna stretch out that main footage a bit so that it overlaps slightly. And in the upper left under Transitions, I wanna find the Dissolve transition. I'm gonna bring that down and put it right at the end of this track and have the Dissolve start right about where the other tracks come in. One other thing I want to do before I forget is in this Greetings From section, I want to make it look like it's actually being written. So if I left click on that track and choose Advanced, and in the Animation section, I want to find the typewriter effect. Now if I've done this right, as this starts to play, it should come towards the portion where we want it to change. And it will slowly dissolve into these other pieces. Pretty cool, huh? Now we have that cool-looking postcard effect, and with a little music under it, it'll really come together. If you want to learn more Filmora tricks, tips, and techniques, click on the videos on screen now and the ones I'll leave down in the description below. You guys stay safe out there, okay? Peace.